everyone, Draco Magnius here for another episode of Let's Play Dragon Quest VIII Journey of the Cursed King. In the last episode, we fought the ugly blob baby lightning bug thing that is Rhapthorne and lost. Then I did some things like go to a secret dungeon and get Yangus one of his new weapons from Red. In this episode, we're going to try and beat Rhapthorne up there, but let me show you. Everyone leveled only once, but I got the Ruinous Shield out of the Alchemy Pot, and now it's the Metal King Shield. I'm just going to Yangus to... Oh, it already is equipped. Never mind. Show you that he has two Yggdrasil dues that I figured I'd give him. Jessica has the scholar specs, so her magical spells will be stronger. And I don't think I gave Angelo anything except for the Sage's Stone, because I learned the Sage's Stone has infinite uses on it, and it has the same thing as multi-heal. So yeah. There was something else. Oh, I got these boxer shorts off Caped Capers, and I used one with the Robe of Evasion to make the Robe of Serenity. So yeah. Was there anything else that I wanted to... Oh, and then, you know, Yangus has the Silver Shield, and I already said I have the Metal King Shield. Also, I'm missing some cheeses because I tried this once already, and it did not go so well. I lost the recording because I accidentally hit cancel. Also, I didn't beat him, so yeah, it's not that bad. So yeah, just gonna fight Rhapthorne now with the strategy I have on the other side of the screen, because I'm using everything I can to try and beat the bastard.
Pitiful humans! Even after so many failed attempts to stop me, you still labor in the hope that you can come between me and my destiny!
I'm sorry, so many, it's twice, you idiot. Learn to count. Or is your body so fat that all the blood needs to run everything else except for your brain?
But your hope is trickling away. Soon it will be gone, leaving only despair.
Uh-huh.
And the further you fall into its black depths, the stronger my flesh and blood shall become.
You guys can't tell, but I'm mocking him by mimicking his mouth movements. I'm also doing the hand-talking thing to mock him. Yeah, 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 blah, blah, blah. Make with the fight! Oh, I forgot to switch my weapon back to the liquid metal sword. You know, I forgot to mention, I almost have the entire Metal King armor set. I just need the armor, but I'm not exchanging it because sacred armor is too useful. Let's see. According to this, I should have Hero Psych up and Yangus Psych up. Have Jessica, I think it says, cast Oomph on... Wait, let's see. Oh no, I'm sorry. They want us to cast Magic Barrier and Angelo to cast... Kabuff. There we go. And if he uses that stupid ice move, I'm gonna be pissed. The ice thing, right? Because I looked away from the screen for 2 seconds. Well, whatever. Okay. Now, next turn... Wait, really? That says we should psych up again. And Jessica should cast Oomph. Well, let's... Oh, wait, am I reading the wrong one? I might be reading the wrong one. Next turn... No, yeah, it says psych up again. Jessica casts Oomph on Hero, and Angela will probably need to heal. And trust me, you want to follow this because I got screwed over for not healing right now. So, yeah, that's what we're going to do. We're just going to follow this to a T. Except for on the turn where I decide I am going to say bitch please and summon Team Dresuvius, a.k.a. my three golems. What the fuck?! Sorry guys, it randomly stopped working and I have no idea what point it ended on. My bad, I apologize, and this is probably gonna suck. Especially if I don't do too well. Alright, we're back. We're back. Now, Falcon Slash. Yeah, because I just psyched up and they're both oomped. Yangus is asleep, unfortunately. What does she do if everyone is oomphed? I guess I could Insulatl. I feel like I'll Kafrizz. And I'll Sage Stone. Okay. Ah, crap. I should now that I think about it- Ah, crap, baskets. Oh, hey, he's not dead. That's good. We'll also use Sage Stone next turn, but I guess I'll have Jessica use Bounce next turn instead of this. Both Yangus and Gileon used Psych Up, right? I think so. You know what? I'm just going to assume they didn't have them both attack this turn, because I hate the whole psyching up maneuvers. No, not Oomph. I want Bounce, and I want Angelo to once again use the Sage Stone. Okay. And since I have the Sage Stone, it can heal Jessica without having to worry about, you know, it being bounced away. Oh, and I should have used Insulatl too. Oh well. Well, Kaboom is gonna hit that bounce, so he's getting a Kaboom. Take that! Okay. No, I guess they didn't, psych up that turn. Well, I'll psych them up then. Okay. Psych. Psych. Insulatl. Sage Stone. Okay. Angelo, you just keep on using that Sage Stone, boy. I'll use Magic Barrier. Actually, no. It seems like it's doing just fine. Okay. Damn it. Alright. So far, it's not doing terrifyingly horrible. They both psyched up, so yes, it's both time for them to do that. They both have an Oomph on, so time to Kafrizz his ass. And once again, of course, use the Sage Stone, because I trust it the most. Oh, and now he just did the stupid thing. His body flashes, great. Attack Jessica, you asshole. Alright, anyway... With that, the guide suggests that you spend this turn psyching your ass up and doing nothing else till it goes away. But since only Angelo and Jessica got hit by it, I don't really have to worry about that since they're playing buff and heal at this point in time. With the occasional attack from Jessica, but Angelo's doing nothing but buff. Jessica was the only one that got hit by it, then... You know what? That's what I'm gonna do. And let's Sage Stone up! Ah, crap baskets. Yeah, that's inopportune, I agree. The guide says he does that always at the worst possible time. Okay, now, since they're both psyched, it's time to give them that. I think I should probably Magic Barrier before I give them the oomph. So yeah, let's Magic Barrier them. I'm gonna have Angelo use nothing but the Sage's Stone to make sure if anyone gets incredibly low on health, we're fine. Okay, I'm dazzled, which sucks, but oh well. See, that's why I'm using the Sage's Stone to heal. Then I guess I'll use the bounce, and then I'll start oomphing. Psych. Psych. Bounce. Okay, Angelo really only has to heal Yangus right now, so... You know, it's still Sage's Zone. I'm not deterring myself from this, because for all I know, someone could get hit horribly and this could end badly if I don't do anything. Oh, and I should have casted Insulatl as well. Oh well. See? That's why I use the Sage's Stone. Again. Every time Angelo moves, he's using that stone, dammit. Okay. And time for another Sage Stone heal! I wish that happened sooner. Eh, oh well. Alright, now we're making business here. No, I don't think I need the guide up right now, so... Shit. Alright, you know what, Gillian's just gonna stay asleep for a little while then. Because I don't want to waste his turn. Now psyching. Oomphing. Healing. Bouncing! Yeah. And you get to hit yourself with another kaboom! Congratulations, Rhapthorne! You are so smart. By smart, I mean you're an idiot. Reverse. In Bizarro World, you're intelligent. Those of you who don't know, Bizarro World is in the DC universe of comics. It's where everything is opposite. So yeah. So in Bizarro Universe, Rhapthorne would be incredibly intelligent, and it would be very bad for us. Okay. Alright, so both Gillian and Yangus are oofed. Angelo is going to use his healing this entire time, so let's attack the Kefrizzle. And let's use the Sage Stone. Again. But of course you know that because I'm not deviating from that plan, so why I bothered to say that, I don't know. Ah, crap baskets. Why would you do it twice? It's kind of pointless if you do it twice. Yes, he's dead! Oh, yeah! God, I was so worried in the beginning that I'd have to reset this to get my items back and train off screen. I'd, of course, tell you guys if I did that, but, you know. And that makes 5 times we've beaten you, you fat lightning bug freak. So now the score is 5-7. I'm not counting the ones he beat me off screen. Aww, the baby's crying. The hell is this? He melted into orange goo. Okay. The spells affecting the party miraculously wear off. The party is fully healed. I like that. Thank you very much. So, now what? We've killed Rhapthorne. I guess we just leave? Okay. You know what? I'm just gonna leave this room first before I evac out, because for all I know, there might be a cutscene coming up. Told ya. And then the castle crumbles just like. Oop.
We've got to get out of here.
You know, we have the spell evac. I can just warp us out of here at any point in time. Seriously. It wouldn't be hard. Ah, damn it. Fine, I'll run. If that's what you really want, game, I will run. Don't see why I couldn't just warp it. Well, maybe Rhapthorne, now that we've killed him, his spirit is enveloping the entire castle, bringing it down, and keeping us from warping out, because he's like, you're not getting out of here alive! I should probably get running instead of looking around the scenery. Okay. Not going that way. Well, this is a very pleasant stroll through the castle. Tra-la-la-la-la. Oh my god, the light! It burns! You're kidding me. Oh, and a new enemy, I guess. Servant of Darkness. You son of a bitch. Rhapthorne made this here as a defense mechanism. You know what? Fuck it, Mazin, come on in. Show him who's boss. The crackle. Meh. The dancing flames aren't going to be difficult. It's the middle guy, the Servant of Darkness, that I'm worried about. But apparently they were worried about the dancing flame for some reason. Maybe because it has No, but so does the Servant of Darkness. I was going to say maybe it's because he can spew fire, but as we just saw, so can the middle one. And it has Kakrackle and other things, I'm sure. Oh, now I get why they made us walk through for this whole run-and-battle scene. They're probably going to give us more of these guardians all over the place, aren't they? If so, I'm going to be kind of annoyed. You know, considering. Oh, I thought it said the Servant of Darkness spews darkness. That would have been cool. Down he goes! Nice! A lot of experience from that, too. Wait, is it me? Or did we not get any experience at all from beating Rhapthorne? Holy crap, that's right! We didn't get any experience from Rhapthorne! Or Rhapthorne, what the hell, game? I guess I walk through the poison field. Wait a minute. These statues reformed except for the heads, but the stairs didn't. I have no idea what the hell we're gonna do. I mean, we're kinda stuck in here. Not kinda, we are stuck in here. Unless I can... No, I can't get through here. Let's try jumping this way, or not jumping, running through that way, because, you know, we can't jump over the poison, that would be silly. I don't know what we're gonna do. Ha-ha! Seriously, where the hell do we go? Starting to panic now. Wait, I see a staircase. Oh, thank God. Oh, wait, and this one is, statues full except for mine, which my head fell off. Oh, maybe because we defeated Rhapthorne, the entire illusion just went away. Or maybe it didn't, and I'm stuck here. Really, game? Really? Or, wait, I have another theory now. We keep running around in circles like we did to get in here, and it keeps restoring instead of deteriorating. Yeah, that's what it looks like, because everything just got better, I think. Well, this is a nuisance. Well, at least nothing's attacking us until we go around the statue again and it comes to life again, probably. Alright, we're back here already. And all the heads are...